Hello friends, welcome you in the field session. Today we will learn how to calculate the dip and strike in the field. Okay, so here we have a exposure here. So here we can calculate, this is a over inclined plane. So basically, first of all, what method we can use? We have two traditional methods. One is dry sand dropping method. Another one is we can use the water also. So suppose that I drop a water over this plane. So what happened? Water follow the dip direction movement here. So this dip direction will be over apparent dip direction. Okay, so now we know this is the dip direction. Another method is dry soil. If suppose that I drop the dry soil over this surface, so what happens? The particle of the soil or sand will follow the gravity towards the dip direction. So this dip direction will be over apparent dip direction. Always remember, this is not true dip direction, this is apparent dip direction. Now we know this is over dip direction. So what we have to do here, we have to mark first of all strike here. So here we have a method that is known as 00 method. So what we have to do with the help of Brunton compass, we have to bring all these scale, three scale. One is 60 to 60, that is known as vernier. Another one is 90 to 90 at 00. You can see here, all these are on 00 along a particular line. So what we have to do now, we have to put our Brunton compass from the base side over the inclined plane. And what now we have to rotate the Brunton compass in this manner that over long bubble or cylindrical bubble will comes into center line. So we have to mark the trace of this Brunton compass through this plane. So it will be over horizontal line over this inclined plane. From the definition of the strike, what is the definition of the strike? Strike definition is, strike is a horizontal line, or we can say strike is an imaginary horizontal line on a inclined plane that show the maximum extension of the strata and measured in vertical section. Okay, so now we know this is our strike direction, or this is this line follow the strike of the strata. Now we have to put our Brunton compass along this strike line so that the edges of the Brunton compass parallel to the mark line. Now we bring our circular bubble in the center and read one reading. Here you can read south direction also, or you can read north direction also, because strike has two direction. So this is approximately 160 degree. I am talking about 160 degree in three digits. Okay, so this is 160 degree. Now we have to measure the dip direction. So this is our apparent dip direction. Now what we can do, we put our Brunton compass perpendicular to our mark strike line over the surface. Now we have to rotate this base up to that position where circular bubble come at the center point. Okay, so here our circular bubble at the center. Now we can measure the, because here object pinpoints is towards our dip direction, so we have to read the north reading. So here the dip direction is 070 degree. So this is northeast, we can say this is northeast direction. Now we have to measure the dip amount. So what we have to do here, we have to put our Brunton compass parallel to our dip direction and rotate the cylindrical bubble by back rotating point. Okay, so now you can see here the cylindrical bubble comes in the center. So you can see the vernier caliper center point over the 90-90 scale. So this is approximately 57 degree. So the strike is 160 degree, dip direction is 070 degree, and dip amount is 57 degree. So here, this is the end, how we can use this to calculate the dip direction. This Brunton compass have another function also. So here there is no need to rotate this clip to bring the cylindrical bubble in the center. Similarly, you can, or directly you can put your Brunton compass here perpendicular to your strike direction, and you can see this scale here, because the circular bubble at center here is also one scale. You can see the base is horizontal. So now you can read the dip amount here. This is approximately 60 degree. Okay, so there is no need to put or incline your Brunton compass like this. In this Brunton compass, this facility here, so you can read the dip amount from here also. So with this note, this is the end of the video. I hope you will enjoy this video. Thank you very much.